A very good morning. You're watching Proactive London, and joining us this morning from Zephyr Energy is Colin Harrington. Great to see you, Colin.
Nice to see you, Katie. Good morning.
Good morning. So you've updated your Paradox Basin independent reserves and your reserve evaluation as well. So we're going to go through all of the details of that and much, much more. And of course, we're talking about the results from your long-awaited competent persons report. It's now been released. Let's maybe go through the headlines of that, Colin.
Yeah, we're absolutely delighted. It's lovely to have an independent look at our reserves and something which, you know, confirms our belief in the huge value and scale that is in front of us. So, you know, CPR is a snapshot in time. We had one done in 2018. And since that time, obviously, we've made huge progress on this asset. So this is a nice look again that kind of confirms the success that we've had both with the drill bit and all the data we've gathered over the last year. Three really important things that it's done. For the first time, we've been able to book 2P reserves on this asset. Our contingent numbers, the 2C numbers, have more than doubled at this point, which is very, very exciting. And we've had a first look and independent assessment of the overlying reservoirs and the prospective resources that might underlie those. So all of those together in this report, and happy to dig in, but we're really, really happy with the progress that's been made here.
All right, good stuff. Well, let's maybe kind of drill down now into these proved reserve figures first. What exactly do they tell us?
Well, you know, first of all, on the 2P side, we've been given credit for the success at the State 16-2. And some credit for acreage that we've acquired in to the south in the Cane Creek field, which is the oily field there. And as we drill up more wells in the coming year, that number will continue to grow. On a 2P basis, we've been given credit for roughly 22 million NPV of proved reserves there. And that's using a fairly conservative oil and gas price deck. Really importantly, when you combine this with what we've done in the Williston over the last year, our company corporate-wide proved reserves are now over $111 million. It's a great foundation of value for everything else we want to do. We've hedged out a lot of that production. The substantial majority of the proved reserves are PDP producing reserves right now. And we think that is a really solid number to peg off and to help accelerate all of the growth that we see in front of us in the contingent and prospective side of things.
All right. Well, let's maybe talk about that further, because it appears that your contingent resource figure is grown substantially. How's that?
Well, I think, to begin with, the contingent reserves are all in the Cane Creek reservoir. So we're not looking at anything beside any of the overlying reservoirs in that. The number's more than doubled from the last CPR. It's got a wide range of potential values on it. And I think it's important when you look at that wide range, you know, between 2C and 3C, for example, what you're seeing there is not just upside from additional reserve growth, but also in the fluid mix. And as you may remember, when we drilled the State 16-2 well, there was a lot of gas, a lot more gas than we had initially expected there. And the wells that have been drilled around us historically have been more oily. So, you know, we're very, very happy to, you know, in this gas price environment to have a lot of gas there. But if the fluid mix evolves back to the more historical ratio in this area, you'd see not just an increase in reserves, but also a substantial increase in the NPV, many, many multiples above where it is on a 2C basis. So, those are pretty staggering numbers just from this Cane Creek reservoir alone. Again, there are a lot of risks as we go about this. We've got to handle, you know, the high pressures here. We've got to better understand the fluid mix and things like, you know, water saturation, if there would be water issues in any other part of this field. But we're very happy to have more credit in the 2C category. And we're also looking forward to drilling up a bit more and being able to move those into proved resources over the coming year.
All right. So for the first time, you've got estimates regarding your prospective resources. How were they estimated, though?
Well, this is the hugely exciting part. And as you remember, these are a number of overlying reservoirs above the Cane Creek, never been tested before. But we've always had historical data from legacy wells, which showed hydrocarbons. And in the last year, we took cores from all of those reservoirs, and we actually saw hydrocarbons and movable hydrocarbons in those. So with that, we were able to have Sproul take an estimate in these reserves. We're looking at 8 high-graded targets. And, you know, the numbers are, again, pretty staggering. On an unrisked basis, over 200 million barrels of oil equivalent, contained or recoverable in those potential reservoirs, we've risked that down to about 74 million barrels using a 37% chance of success. But again, it's important, you know, this is exploration, but it's not conventional exploration because we know that there are hydrocarbons there based on the work we've done so far. So really, this exploration is to see not simply if there's hydrocarbon there, but if it's economic to get it out. We're drilling an exploration well in the next few months there. And should that be successful, then you're going to see a huge shift from prospective to contingent or even proved reserves in these categories too. So it's a huge amount of upside that if we do this right and we manage the risks right, could have a many multiples again of value on top of this.
All right, let's maybe move on and talk about your upcoming drilling plans.
Yeah, so we're fully funded to do 3 wells this year. That's funding from our existing cash and from all the cash flows that are kicking off of our proved reserves at the moment, our producing reserves. So we are drilling 3 wells that are strategically placed to try to delineate the value here and really help us understand what this resource looks like. So we'll do 1 in the Cane Creek in a different part of our federal unit, but targeting with a hydraulic stimulation, the same reservoir that we did with the State 16-2 this year. We're doing 1 to the south of us and on our acreage in the Cane Creek field, which also has the Cane Creek Reservoir. I can't stand that they have the same names, but they do. And that's in a more oily area, and that'll help us understand our new acreage to the south. And then lastly, as I said, we'll have this exploration well that we're drilling that will help us begin to quantify the overlying reservoirs. We're in a very good place, having just locked in $30 million of revenue over the next 2 years through our hedges with BP. We're well funded for this, and we're really looking forward to commencing this in the second half of the year.
All right. And how do kind of all these pieces, how do they all come together in terms of a company value perspective, Colin?
So I think it's important, again, to step back and remember in March last year, we had 0 proved reserves and 0 production and a contingent number that was about 12 million barrels of oil equivalent in the 2C category. And you fast forward to now, and company-wide, we have more than 111 million of proved reserves, much of which is producing at this point. So it's a great, great foundation of cash flow and value on which you layer all of these other pieces. So I'm really thrilled with the substantial increase in the 2C. And obviously, we see a huge amount of value in the prospective exploration. And we're moving forward very quickly to try to target that. We've been measured in how we've approached this field. It's taken us a long time to gather the right data and pieces. But I think today is a very nice independent look at how that value has grown over time. And also you can see a clear path forward to, through this next set of drilling to really quantify the remainder of the value in this field and hopefully have not just, many hundred millions of barrels of oil and gas equivalent on top of this, but in terms of an NPV basis, something that's much more valuable than where we are today. So I'm, as you can tell, pretty excited about this path forward. We've got a lot of hard work in front of us. We have risks remaining, but we are proceeding ahead very carefully, but expediently to quantify it.
All right, sounds good. Well, thank you very much. That's Colin Harrington there from Zephyr Energy discussing your update, Paradox Basin independent reserves and the resource evaluation as well this morning here on Proactive.
Thanks, Katie. Nice to see you.